Gentlemen, welcome back. You're back with MGTOW Money. Today's topic is going to be put down that crack pipe and get over your female addiction. Before we get to that, though, I want to sincerely thank the latest Patreon supporters. In particular, I want to thank Pontus. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining the MGTOW Army, the MGTOW Money Army as we move this forward. And thank you, of course, towards all those gentlemen who bought me a cup of coffee via PayPal. See the video description to do so. I do sincerely appreciate it. Let's roll on to today's topic right now. This is in a bit of reaction to a recent video that Stardusk did on his Thinking Ape channel. I shouldn't say that it's a reaction. He just brought something to my attention that, frankly, it goes to show how out of touch I am with modern culture, where he was talking about men giving hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars to women who are doing these YouTube videos and these guests, Twitch stream videos, etc. Again, I'm totally out of the loop, I guess, when all this comes into play. By the way, I will include, of course, a link in the description to his video for those of you who may not have seen it. It's very good, by the way. But needless to say, this whole idea of virtual girlfriends is, frankly, bizarre to me. However, let me put a caveat to that. I do have, unfortunately, in years past, I, John Galt, have given, frankly, thousands of dollars to women. I was not married to them for other reasons, to help them, support them, whatever. And frankly, now in hindsight, I term that a matter of temporary insanity. And it is definitely something, frankly, that was not my proudest moment. So let me make that clear right off the bat. But let me just say, though, gentlemen, if any of you are doing that, if any of you are giving money to women in this virtual girlfriend sense, frankly, stop doing it. Let me, though, move on, though, in terms of why you might be doing it, why you probably are doing it. Because, again, I think it's important to understand, before you overcome something, you've got to understand why are you doing it. Then you've got to understand how you can overcome it. So I do think that there is a natural instinct in men to, first of all, they want to be liked by women. They want to be validated by women. And frankly, for 80% of us, for 80% of men, for most men, they're ignored by women. We're a ghost to women. But men instinctually, they want to be liked, they want to be validated, they want to be seen as a tool to women, they want to support women, they want to be sort of that white knight, that man that gets the, you know, that gets the pat on the head from the girl or whatever. The point is, I understand. This is a natural instinct, though, that you can overcome. By the way, one of the benefits I think that you're going to find as you get older is that you're going to need that feeling less and less. I further understand that a lot of men continue to associate with women, in particular at younger ages, because they don't want to feel lonely, because they want to feel like, well, someone loves me, because someone approves of me, because they don't want to feel like some sort of social outcast. I mean, we live in a society, generally speaking, especially in the Western world, where everything is about couples, where everything is about he and she, and even just male and male, female and female nowadays. But this whole craving of societal approval, where, hey, I've got somebody who, quote, loves me, etc. I get it. I get it, gentlemen. I've been there. I do understand. You're going to do effectively whatever you can to get a woman's approval. And again, I further understand that for 4 out of 5 of us, that doesn't come easily and that doesn't come cheaply. With that said, though, I've got some things that you need to consider that it is costing you, gentlemen. That's more than just money. But before I get to that, that's more than just money. It is costing you money. Because no matter what happens, gentlemen, you are having to put money towards that woman. I recently read a survey among young female MD students, medical doctor students. Guess what their preferred marriage rate was in terms of, when I say marriage rate, I'm defining that in terms of the type of guy that they're looking for. Surprise, surprise, they're looking to marry other serious high-income white-collar professionals. Frankly, they're not looking to marry the average Joe, gentlemen. Again, these women are going to be presumably making easily six figures in the not-too-distant future once they get through medical school. They're looking to at least marry at their equal level or higher, gentlemen. The point is, the more you're getting involved with women, the more that it's going to cost you money-wise. And so the first thing I want you to think about is, before you start giving any money to women, the first thing I want you to think about is, what is it costing you relative to something tangible you could purchase with that same money? Could you pay off some debts? Could you put it towards an investment? Let's say you could take that $100 that you're about to give that girl, maybe you could turn it into $200 or $300. The point is, always think about, is there something else I could do with this money? This physical money in my hand, could I do something more productive with it? Could I do something that has a much more lasting, long-term impact with this money? Number two, another issue that I know that many of you deal with when you're around women, and in particular, as you're getting more and more involved with women, is that you lose your focus. Again, speaking from my own personal experience, it can be very difficult to have a clear mind with no distractions to where you're pursuing your goals and moving forward with your life and succeeding in your life when you're dealing with, frankly, a woman who is, let's just hypothetically say, as most of them are, and I shouldn't say hypothetically, most of them literally are, they are human beings, they're not human doings. It is not a cliche to say that. Yes, of course, there are some circumstances where women can be inspirational. Yes, there are some circumstances where women can actually be helpful, etc. I would describe those circumstances as being very, very few and far between. Furthermore, I've been around women who, frankly, are successful, goal-driven, etc. I didn't like to be around them. I don't like to feel that necessarily that undue pressure on myself. I've got enough pressure on that I can apply to myself already. I'm good. I don't need anybody else to apply it to me. I just want you to think about, gentlemen, what if you and you alone could focus your mind on achieving your goals? You've got a clear head. You got a clear mind. You're moving forward. You've got no distractions. I want you to think about how much more you could achieve if you're doing that without those human beings around you. And you know what I'm talking about when I say human beings. All right, let's continue on with this. I also understand the pain of potential loneliness. And so many of you are thinking, I don't want to be lonely. That's why I'm still with this girl. I just can't deal with it. I can't deal with that stigma, that sense of loss of not having a girl around, or even not to have another human being, but again, in particular, a girl. Let me just tell you the most difficult form of loneliness that you will ever deal with. That form of loneliness takes place when you're with someone, in particular with a girl, and you're feeling lonely. I guarantee you, you will not feel a depth of loneliness deeper than that. That is extremely difficult to handle. So my point is, you've got to become comfortable being alone. And what I'm going to recommend is, there's a cheap little book, again, I'll include it in the video description, that I encourage you to read about, if nothing else, liking yourself, accepting yourself. It's extremely important, and this can take a while. It could take you a long time, and most people probably won't ever be able to achieve it. But if you want to have any sense of contentment in your life, you've got to learn to at least accept and like yourself. Now, gentlemen, let me summarize. Your female addiction, yes, it is an addiction, is costing you money. It's going to cost you achieving your goals. I'm not saying you can't achieve your goals, but it's just going to make it that much more difficult. You're creating barriers that are going to be that much harder to overcome. And furthermore, just as importantly, it's going to make it more difficult for you to find contentment in your life. Again, I didn't say happiness, I said contentment in your life. Whether you choose to move forward on these ideas or some variation, I would encourage you to consider other outlets for connecting with women, if you will. Let's just say, without getting into details, there are other outlets, whether it be pay for play, whether it be for video type stuff, let's just say that, etc. I'll let you fill in the blanks there, gentlemen. Again, questions you need to be asking yourself when you're dealing with women. What is this costing me? Not just financially, what else is this costing me? Are there other costs that I'm taking on here? Can I get this same type of effect from something else or from no one else? I think you'll find, gentlemen, that you can get most of the same effects, the most of the same feelings that you want ultimately in other outlets, frankly, that are much less costly financially, emotionally, etc. All right, gentlemen, that's it. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Hit the like button if you found that useful. As always, John Galt out.